Hello you lovely people of internet land, and welcome to the video. Just a quick one. I wanted to do an update on this before I send it out, because yes, it has sold, and what you all want to know is how much did it sell for. Welcome back to my office. If you are new to the channel, maybe you found the channel recently because of what's been going on with the cartridge, welcome. My name is Nick, and I sell stuff on the internet to earn a living, and on this channel we talk about all the aspects of running an online business. So quickly, for those that aren't up to speed, we listed this cartridge, which is a Nintendo development cartridge with WWF No Mercy on it. I made a video about the cartridge and about its the history that I know about that specific cartridge and what development cartridges are in general, and I linked to the auction we had set up, because as I explained in that video, I wasn't really sure what potentially it would sell for. I discussed in that video that similar cartridges had sold anywhere from a few hundred pounds right up to maybe £1,000 could be possible. I really wasn't sure. So we elected to put it on a 99 pence auction, because there is enough demand for those and enough collectors and enough interest that I felt safe it would get bids and it would find its price. But what actually happened was a lot of people had a lot of fun on that auction and bid it crazy high. It ended up at over £60,000, and it was very obvious that people were bidding with no intention to pay. So we ended the listing and relisted it as a buy it now with offers on. I quickly want to talk about a couple of questions that have come up a lot on that other video and on our live stream on Sunday about what happened, and tackle those. Firstly, a lot of people said, how did we know that those weren't genuine bids? Maybe people did really want to pay that. There was talk that it was a famous wrestler was bidding on it, and they were prepared to pay a fortune for it. They weren't genuine bids, 100%. How do I know? Because I was messaging a lot of the high bidders and asking them what their intention was. Did they intend to buy it? And it became very clear they didn't. And then when you consider we ended it and we listed it on a buy it now with a fixed price way below all of the crazy high bids that were going on, those bidders, if they were serious, they would have bought it at the buy it now price. So none of it was serious. The second thing that was being talked about all over the place was how greedy I was with the buy it now price of £10,000. That was just a complete arbitrary figure. We had no perception that it was worth that, but we listed it there and then left it open to offers. We were kind of doing it backwards, because the auction was kind of, it went crazy and was kind of ruined. We listed it with a ridiculously high buy it now that we didn't think it was worth, and then we invited people to make offers, which they did, and we had lots and lots of offers in, and we accepted one of those offers. And also, I had a little, just a fun side bet going on with Alan, who's the chap who found this cartridge originally, about how much it would sell for. My prediction was £600, Alan's was £500. Well, I won the side bet because I was closest. And what this has actually sold for is £1,000. So there you go. That's what it sold for. We're very happy with that. I think that was the max we could have got out of it. And I think that's a fair price for what it is, judging by similar cartridges. Those ones that I shared in that video, a pair sold for £2,000. And they were sold as seen untested with no idea what was on them. We know what's on this. It's got that nice bit of provenance with the reviewer's name on it and other stuff. So yeah, there you go. That's what it sold for. It's going out today. I was going to possibly just drive it to the buyer. They are in the UK. But I'm going to send it. I'm going to ship it special delivery, and I'm really pleased. So let me know what you think. Do you think that was a fair price? I think it is. I think that's, if anything does have a market value, I think that's about right for this. It's actually more than I predicted, but I did have a sneaking suspicion that it could reach a grand. I thought anything beyond that would be crazy. Yeah, but it was fun. It was a really entertaining weekend. I think a lot of people were very intrigued by what this thing would sell for. So I thought I would share what it's actually gone for. So for the video that I'm going to dig out from the archive and link today, we'll stick with the Nintendo theme. I will dig out a haul video when I picked up a massive collection of gaming, and I think I did 3 or 4 haul videos, but I will dig out the Nintendo one and link it up here. So check that out if you haven't seen it before. Thank you so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you soon.